Under the road collapsed at Kwafoti due to heavy rains. Motorists have had to use a detour since the collapse a week ago. Persistent heavy rain has caused localized flooding, exacerbating the problem. This road is also an important arterial road in the Eastern Cape. Nkululeko Nyembezi is there for us this morning. Nkululeko, a very good morning to you. What's the latest?
Thank you very much to you and to the viewers at home. Yeah, we are here at on the R61 road, the road that cuts across between the Mthatha and Queens town. As you can see, that motorists from the other side of the road, or from Queenstown, they just drop the passengers on the other side of the road, and then they had to cross the bridge and then take another transport on the other side. So it's a very awkward situation. Elderly people with babies on their back, with luggages on their back, they had to walk a short distance. They have to cut their journey short. But as you can see, there's a truck right next to us, which is offloading bricks material, building material. They have to take that material on their hands because they cannot cross this particular part of the road. But now I'm joined by the spokesperson of Transport Department in the Eastern Cape, Mr. Unathi Pingose. Mr., thank you very much for joining us. This is really a bizarre situation, if I may put it that way.
It certainly is, my brother, and it is something that we cannot apologize enough for to the people of the Eastern Cape. But the people of South Africa ought to understand that this is largely due to the torrential and persistent rains that have battered the province, kept it soaked for the past 3 to 4 weeks, and that is what has resulted to this. However, we are working around the clock to ensure that this situation is sorted out. And I can speak with confidence that the Premier of the province, Umnomzane Oscar Mabuyane, has written directly to the Minister of Transport in the in South Africa, Minister Fikile Mbalula, asking for intervention. And we are awaiting to hear what is to transpire from that. But we ought to applaud as well Sanral for their prompt response, because a day after this incident happened, their engineers were here, but their planes were somewhat disturbed by the torrential rains that poured in the province in the past 2 days. But we are working around the clock to ensure that this situation is not carrying on for long.
Let's talk about the short-term solution, because I can see that traffic is being diverted, but there is an outcry from motorists that there are no signs that really show that they had to detour here, this is a detour or not. What's the situation? Why is that?
That is truly the case. I've done a bit of a drive around here to see for myself what the situation is. While we are awaiting that signage, we do have law enforcement officers that are on the ground diverting and directing traffic, and we're pleading with motorists and road users in general to obey the instructions they are getting from those officers. But in terms of the short-term solution, ideally would want to have a bypass that is not going to be far from this road itself. However, in the meantime, we are asking our people to please use the directions, or rather the diversions that are being passed on to them by their law enforcement officers. I can see some of them are already here, so we commend them for their dedication, and we apologize sincerely to the road users for the inconvenience here.
So as a department, are you going to make sure that at least this gravel road is usable, it was usable friendly, because there's an outcry from the motorists also that even the detour are not usable?
The detour were usable prior to the rains that fell over the past 2 days. But the past 2 days have somewhat washed off all that effort that was put in there. But our senior engineer is already here, and she has gone to inspect that road. And not only that, she has ensured that we do have people that are working on that road to get it to the state that we want it to be in order to be able to handle the volume of traffic that is set to be diverted to that road. Those engineers are already there now, and we are just awaiting an excavator that we expect it will be there no later than midday today to start preparing that road for the volume of traffic that we anticipate is going to be using that stretch of the road. It's not ideal. Ideally, really, really want to have this road up and running again, because we can see the inconvenience that it is causing to our people. I mean, the fact that they have decided to rather transfer themselves from this side of the bridge to the other side, feeling that it was a better option than using the detours. And we know that even motorists have to dig even deeper into their pockets to use these bypasses, because they add a bit of time and they will certainly take up a bit of fuel from their vehicle. So we commend them for their industriousness, for thinking on their feet and taking the initiative that they have taken to simply transfer passengers from one side of the bridge to the other. So we commend them for that, and we commend the taxi industry and all the public transport operators that have taken that initiative.
Thank you very much, sir. That was Unathi Bhinqosi. He's a spokesperson for the transport department. As you can see, people are moving up and down trying to cross the small pitch of the damaged part of the road, but they are promising that at least they will try by all means to fix this with immediate effects. As he is saying that the plans are on the way to make sure that at least this thing is resolved. Back to studio.
Right, let's take a look at your weather prospects as we prepare for the top